Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 609, and today's topic is nutrition and health benefits of chickpea, and which is known as Kabuli Chana in India. In India, it is very popular, it is widely used as a vegetable, and this belongs to leguminaceae family. It is actually legume. And as you know, all the legumes, they are very rich in folate, B complex and polyphenolics. But there is a specialty in this little bit more. They are also rich in protein, that is vegetable protein. But for this chickpea, that is your Kabuli Chana, is the best substitute of animal protein in India. Those who are not taking animal protein, they should go for chickpea, and they can be substituted with this vegetable protein of chickpea. It is very rich in protein, and it is prepared in different varieties, sometimes soup, sometimes gravy, like chole chana and chole bature. I mean, lot of preparations are there with potato. Sometimes it is prepared as a gravy, and people, they enjoy, and not only in India but in Europe also it is very popular nowadays, even in America. And actually the history of chickpea goes that it is from Middle Eastern countries, some even thousands of years ago, they started cultivating and using. And then slowly it is spread throughout the world, and now it is used in most of the countries, and it has a very good nutritional and health benefit. I have already told you that it is very rich in protein and folate and vitamin, mineral. Especially when I say vitamin, it is rich in folate, because most of these legume peas, they are all rich in folate, and folate is very powerful anti-inflammatory. And I've already discussed this inflammation in 600 lecture when I discuss this eggplant. Inflammation is very serious issue, and we should not have impression that inflammation means it's only joint pain, arthritis or rheumatoid arthritis or any joint pain or swelling, and we are taking lightly. No, inflammation can happen to any part of the body, to any organ, even to lung. And nowadays, I mean, in this COVID-19 disease by novel coronavirus, everybody is dying because of hyperinflammation, inflammation of lung. And that inflammation of lung is causing organ damage, because this cytokine, or we can say hyperstorm of inflammation of the lung, seizing the supply of oxygen in other part of the body. So inflammation is very serious. Even if there is inflammation in our brain cells, it is a neurodegenerative problem. If there is inflammation in our intestine, this colitis or some other disease will come, and in this way the wall of the intestine will not function normally. So it's not only in joint, it can happen in any part of the body. And inflammation is a very, very serious issue for our normal health. And these compounds which are anti-inflammatory, they are protecting us from internal inflammation. And secondly, these phenolics, they are also protecting us from oxidative stress, like polyphenolics, catechin, tannin, flavonol. So all are present in this, and it is also having mineral, that is potassium, magnesium. That's why it can maintain the blood pressure. and this is very good protein because it will stay for longer time. That's why you will feel fullness, and it is good for our bowel movement, so that if anybody who is having constipation, it can help in that. So why chickpea is more special as compared to other legume peas is that it is rich in saponins. And there are two types of saponins. One is called steroidal saponin, where the egg glycone, this portion is steroid, and where sugar is linked, that is called steroidal saponin. And here, this egg glycone, means non-sugar part, is your terpene, and sugar is linked here with oxygen, and this is called terpenoidal saponin. So chickpea, this kabuli chana, is rich in saponins. And what is the indication for any pea to be rich in saponin? If you soak in water and leave it, after some time there will be soapy, soap foam will be formed, and that soap leather or foam will be stable maybe for 30 minutes, 1 hour, for longer period. That indicates that that particular vegetable or fruit is rich in saponin. And saponins, they also play a very important role. First thing is that they will not allow the oxidation of your solid fat, that is called lipid. It will drastically reduce the LDL, that is low density lipoprotein, and it will maintain the good amount of lipoprotein. It is very good anti-cancerous because it will not allow to have oxidative stress and to get the abnormal cell, that is called cancer cells multiplication and tumor formation. So because of this property, these saponins, they are very, very good from medicinal point of view. And your chickpea is rich in this saponin. Saponin is a type of glycoside with sugar linkage with two nucleus, either steroidal saponin or terpenoidal saponin, and they have lot of medicinal importance for us human beings. Otherwise, these saponins, they are poison for cold-blooded animals, means those animals which are having only two chamber heart like fish. If you put the fish, I mean in pond, this will be so much toxic that these fishes, they cannot sustain saponin and they will die. So it is a fish poison. But for us, it is a very good for anti-cancer and also for lipid to reduce the LDL. Only structure. And another good property of saponins are that it protects our teeth from degeneration. And in Nigeria, 1.5 million Nigerians, they suffer every year from dental degeneration, that is dental caries, and they have cavity formation or sometimes decay. All these problems come and they have to extract out the tooth. So it is, once we are eating all these legumes, at least the chance of the dental teeth degeneration will be less. And here in Nigeria, we have legumes like beans is good source of saponin. So here, the botanical name of chickpea is Sisal arietinum, and it belongs to family leguminaceae. It is a legume, and the 1 ounce, that is 28 gram of chickpea, contains 46 calorie, carbohydrate 8 gram, fiber 2 gram, protein 3 gram, folate 12% of RDI, means reference daily intake. So it is rich in folate, means very powerful anti-inflammatory and phosphorus 5% of RDI, copper 5% of RDI, and magnesium 14% of RDI. And number two, it may help to control appetite by increasing the appetite reducing hormone, because it is high in fiber. So that's why it can control the appetite. Number three, it may help to reduce weight, because I have already told you that it is rich in fiber, and that fiber is slowly broken down into sugar molecule, and that's why it takes lot of time to convert into sugar. Because of that reason, it can reduce the weight. And number four, it support blood sugar control. It is also supporting blood sugar control because it is having low glycemic index. Low glycemic index means where very slowly it is broken down into sugar. It may take 8 hours, 10 hours time, and that's why it is good also for those people who are having diabetic condition or hyperglycemia. Number five, may protect from heart disease because of two reasons, that it contains magnesium and potassium. It is rich, that's why potassium can replace the sodium, and it can control the blood pressure. And magnesium plays very important role for your muscles and to maintain your arteries strength. And it is rich in folate, folic acid, that is B9 group of vitamin, and B1. They are powerful antioxidant, anti-inflammatory. That's why they can help in your cardiovascular problem, and it will reduce drastically the oxidative stress and inflammation. And then also it can reduce the LDL, that is your bad cholesterol, low density lipoprotein, and in general it can also reduce the percentage of triglycerides, that is lipid, in your blood. Number six, it protect from cancer. And if I say protect from cancer, it's very clear indication that it is rich in folate and B group of vitamins. They are powerful antioxidants, and they can drastically reduce the oxidative stress, and that will not allow blood to clot, and there will not be thrombosis or blood clotting formation. And then